welcome back to a new video session. Today's session will be the conclusion part from this chapter, and today's session we will cover the Toiga region as well as the Tundra region. Okay, so these Toiga region, we can name these as coniferous forest. Okay, now the location of the Toiga region, first though it is a coniferous forest as I said, and the location latitudinal extension of the Toiga region is from 55 to 70 degree of north, and the region occurs between the Tundra region and the Tundra region in the north and the tropical grassland in the south. So this is a transition zone between the Tundra and the temperate grassland. I hope this point is clear. Now area wise we will see according to continent. So in North America, this is southern situated at the southern Canada and the southern Alaska, and the north part of Europe, parts of Norway, then Sweden, Finland, and southern part of Russia, and northern part of Asia, that is the northern Siberia, and in the southern America, the mountain part of the southern Chile, and in the Australia, it's New Zealand and Tasmania. So these are the area of the Toiga region. Now we will see the climate. Okay, before I narrate the climatic condition, one thing you need to keep in your mind, that the Toiga region is a cold region. Why? Because if we see the latitudinal extension of the Toiga region, it is 55 to 70 degree of north, right? So we can say that this region is nearer to the polar region. So pole is situated at 90 degree and this region is nearer to the pole region. So that is why the temperature always remain low here. Okay, so let us see the climatic feature from this region. Okay, so long cold winter for 6 months below 0 degree Celsius. So long cold winter we can see here, and the mean temperature here is 10 degree Celsius, and summer is here for 3 to 4 months. Okay, yes, summer are short and summer are for 3 to 4 months, and the temperature during summer, the mean temperature may be 20 degree Celsius. Okay, rainfall varies from 25 to 100 centimeter, and some rainfall that I just said, it is, we can see in the summer season, but in winter we see here snowfall. Okay, yes, snowfall during the winter. So that is all about the climatic condition of the Toiga region. Now natural vegetation, so evergreen forest with softwood and coniferous with the cone shaped trunks and needle like spines, xerophyte vegetation, and the main species that we find in the Toiga region are the pine, fir, spurs, then larch, then hemlock. These are the trees we can get in the Toiga region. Now human adaptation, as we can see the temperature is very cold, so the agriculture is not that much developed in this region, because most of the time the land in the Toiga region is filled with the snow cover. Okay, so the growing season in this region is short, so that is why agriculture didn't develop well. But though some of the crops are grown in this region, so these crops are barley, oats, potatoes, beetroot. These are the crops are grown in this region. So that is all about the Toiga region. We just read the location, then area, then the climatic condition, natural vegetation, and human adaptation. I hope the Toiga region is clear. Next we will see the Tundra region or the cold desert. Tundra region, the location of the Tundra region is beyond the Arctic Circle, and the Tundra region is present in the northern hemisphere rather than the southern hemisphere. And Tundra region means the area that is flat, treeless, and which is boggy. Okay, and beyond the Tundra region lies the area covered with perpetual snow ice called polar ice cap region. The Tundra is found in the northern hemisphere. In the southern hemisphere, the entire continent of Arctic has a permanent ice cap, and Greenland is the largest ice cap in the northern hemisphere. So this is all about the location. Basically the Tundra region is named as the cold desert, and it is situated just north of the Toiga, and they are also situated in the northern hemisphere than the southern hemisphere. Greenland is a largest area yes, of just ice cap, and these region are basically treeless. So that is all about the location. Now in area we see the tundra region in the Northern America, in Asia, and also in Europe. So in Northern America, the Northern Canada and Alaska. In Europe, we see it in the Scandinavia, Greenland, and Iceland. And in Asia, it is located in Siberia. Yes. Now climate. So from the location, it is clear to you all that it is situated at the pole. Okay. So that is why we can assume that the climatic condition is extreme cold here. Okay. So the winter is here for 9 to 10 months, and winter temperature remain -35 to -40 degrees Celsius, and summer is here for 3 months. Okay, and rainfall is very scanty, and these rainfall is cyclonic in nature. Okay, and most of the time of a year is the land is covered with the snow here. Okay, so that is all about the climatic condition and the rainfall that just I talked, that it is scanty, less than 25 centimeter of rainfall occurred here. It is happened during only the 3 to 4 months of summer. Hope it is clear. Now we are moving toward the natural vegetation of the tundra region. So a flat treeless plain which is boggy. And during the short summer season, some flowering, some grasses are there. We can find as they come to life, and they are called as grassy tundra. Okay. Next is common type of vegetation is mosses, then leeches and grasses. Other than that, some flowering plants which are famous in these regions are poppies, lilies, buttercups, then violets are there. And in the southern part, in the Arctic, scrub vegetation with birches, willow, juniper, alder can be seen. So that is all about the natural vegetation. Now the human adaptation, as the area is too much cold, so the cultivation is not developed that much. And also in the summer time, because of the melting of the ices, there is a huge problem of water, melting water in this region. So people mostly who are living here, they depend on the fishing and also in hunting. But nowadays, a new kind of wheat has been introduced in this region for a shorter maturing period, are now being cultivated in the southern part of the tundra region. The southern part has some warm kind of climate, so that is why scientists are trying to cultivate wheat here. Yes, so that is all about the human adaptation. We can see that the extreme type of cold winter is situated in the tundra region or the cold desert region. Yes, so that is all about the tundra region. We have covered the location, then the area, climate, natural vegetation, and human adaptation. I hope the tundra region is clear to you all. And with this region, we have completed the chapter. If you still have any doubt from this chapter, you can ask me. I am there to clear. Thank you all.